Flew is a bit of a renaissance man, a modern day renaissance man.
He serves on multiple committees like the school improvement team.
He's the official scorer of our track and cross country meets.
He also serves as a department chair.
He fostered a student first mindset within the science department, which has really helped us increase our science offerings and our STEM offerings.
The reason I'm here is because of Flewelling. He developed a physics program here that was so good that they had way too many sections of physics and they needed another teacher.
He's the assistant director for our theatrical productions, 3 shows a year in the fall, in the spring, and in the summer.
In the theater department, he's just kind of, he's just a legend. Like, the kids love him.
Without Flew, we wouldn't be where we are in the theater department. His physics is what we needed. It was that last little push that we needed to get over that hump of not having the best production.
I mean, there is such an engineering aspect to theater.
Set pieces, everything that we needed, like flying stuff down, in and out, it all the counterweight and everything like that, he knew how to do that.
He's very much theatrical inclined, which is a part of the beauty of Mr. Flewelling, because in the classroom, that's his stage.
Like, he brings some of his theatrics to the classroom.
My sophomore year, I walked in, and it was a completely different atmosphere I've ever had in any classroom.
He teaches so well. I've never had a better teacher. It's so interactive and engaging, and I totally understood what he was saying when he would explain something.
His class teaching is amazing, but, like, the one-on-one with Mr. Flewelling, it's almost like a different learning experience, because, like, he goes step by step and makes sure you're learning every aspect and making sure you're not getting lost.
He is very patient, and he never gets overwhelmed. He calmly works with each student and answers all their questions.
Flew has that relationship with students. They're able to talk with him on many different levels.
He can build relationships, but then be professional all at the same time.
You can tell he wants to get to know you. Like, he really wants to know his students, and he'll talk about students he's had like 10 years ago that he still keeps in contact with, because he just keeps those relationships.
He's more like a friend, I would say, like a teacher, really, to a lot of students.
We don't really even need to say much to each other. We just kind of, there's like a frequency kind of thing.
He is a superman of an educator, I call it.
He does so much, and, you know, his range of abilities and skills and things that he's able to do, things that he's willing to learn to do, it's above and beyond.
I don't know, it's almost like there's 5 of him. I don't know how.
If you look at him, he kind of looks a little laid back, but Mr. Flewelling's so rambunctious, and, like, he's very active, and he'll, like, run across the room.
He'll literally jump up.
He always jumps up on tables and, like, reiterates, like, concepts you want to understand, or he'll teach from up, like, on top of a table.
Yeah, he's just all around really good guy. If I were to know one person who would be considered a hero, it would be Flew.
When I first met him junior year, I was like, wow, this man has amazing hair. I was like, how do I get some of this hair? And we used to call him Flewelling, because he used to have the amazing hair.
I don't really know where it started. I just heard someone say it. I was like, Flewelling, that makes sense. It's the only word that I can describe his hair as is Flewelling.
And his hair will grow a little bit longer. And one time, it was like last year, I'm like, That hair is getting longer and longer. And then, like, the next time I saw him, it was in the bun, and I was just like, guess he can pull that off.
Obviously, Flew's hair is a little longer, and last year it was, I think, longer than it is now. And so every once in a while he would rock the man bun. Yeah, the man bun, he just reminds me of, like, a beachy dude. Sometimes he'll, like, mess around. He has, like, a nice little flow going on, so he always puts it in a bun. And the students love it, because it's, like, a trend now or something. I don't know.
Oh, the man bun. It was, it was something else. It's its own entity. I don't know how to describe it. It is because it is. Nobody compares to the man bun.
And we just sort of left the man bun alone and figured, you know, he'd get his hair cut eventually, and he did. he did.